Hi, I'm Mark.
I'm Amanda.
And I'm Tom, and you're watching
Welcome to the D.
The top five this week, which are of course our top five, is top five drummers of all time. So why don't we start with our top five.
All right, at number five, I will have to go with Neil Peart from Rush. Very disciplined player to say the least. I mean, you listen to those Rush tunes and it's incredible the discipline that it takes to play those parts that he's got.
So like, I actually came up with fun. Jack Antonoff played for all three, I believe, of their top hits. But I felt like it was a band where the drum defined the band rather than the other way around.
All right, so my number five, I'm gonna have to go with Craig McIntyre, Goo Goo Dolls. He is the current drummer and has been the drummer since 2014, is writing the songs with Johnny and Robbie. So I got a big shout out for you, Craig.
Well, number four, I'm gonna have to go with Buddy Rich. Besides just being an iconic drummer and being an influence to so many people, you can't beat a guy who is doing head cutting with Animal from the Muppets, man.
So. So my number four was Ringo Starr. He's kind of a workhorse guy, steady. You can really count on him. But I think kind of what he's known for is that it's like
being a solid drummer. Well, yeah.
I'm gonna go with the Detroit Elvin Jones, Pontiac, Michigan. A lot of people said he was a good session drummer more than he was anything else.
All right, my number three is from my favorite band of all time, the Jimi Hendrix Experience, Mitch Mitchell. Just a great improvisational drummer. Always just playing wide open with the throttle on 12, not 10.
So my number three was actually Buddy Rich, which we've already spoken about.
My number two, the great Dennis Chambers. What can you say about the guy who played with P-Funk, Santana, Steely Dan, Jackson 5, George Benson, George Duke. Just thrilled to have him on my album, Vicious Tides. Again, and as nice of a guy, as great of a drummer as he is, he's just that humble of a guy. Just really great guy, down to earth.
All right, so my number two, Neil Peart, Rush.
Yeah.
Got to go with the energy there for me. Yeah. For me, that's what makes it. It's a little Rush. Animal-ish. You know, he's got a, there's a lot of fast there.
All right, so I got to say my number two pick, since we've been mentioning Animal, Animal's my number two pick.
Turns out, quintessential drummer.
Quintessential drummer, yes. And if he definitely, he always had his handle on music and he certainly could get the women. But actually, the honest truth, Keith Moon.
Keith Moon.
My number one is Animal now.
Keith Moon. Yeah, Keith, exactly. Keith Moon, who is actually Animal, was modeled after. All right, number one.
Number one, John Bonham. Hands down, the greatest rock drummer in history, one of the greatest drummers in history. I mean, how fast his foot was on that kick drum and those double hits and all that and those triplets was like...
He was phenomenal.
Me too.
So my pick, and I'm gonna be different than these two, Phil Collins. I gotta go with it. Yes,
yeah, when he was...
Yes, Phil
Collins.
Well,
when he was a Brand X especially.
Yeah?
Yeah, when he was a Brand X, he really got to stretch out and do his thing.
He could command a stage all on his own.
One thing this week, a lot of participation.
But before you get to that, I'm gonna flip out and let our producer come in. Tara's gonna come in, she's gonna give her top five. I wanna welcome to our show the producer, Tara, who's behind the scenes and does a lot. So Tara's gonna give her top five.
Well, my number five, I'll bring it back to this time. I'll go with Chad Smith from Red Hot Chili Peppers. Also from Detroit, so you have to support Detroit.
He's from Detroit, it's another Detroit connection. Which I like the Red Hot Chili Peppers. They've always had some unique sound and everything always, they kind of also evolved a lot with the grunge scene.
Exactly, yes.
So they kind of kept up with what was going on with the music scene. I thought they had all of them. Plus also they did all that acting.
Yeah. My number four, I'm going to have to go with Rob Berdon from Linkin Park.
What is it you liked more about Linkin Park?
I think I like that they could transition from anything. They could go from rock, they could go a little more modern, so they could do a little bit of everything. Like, not everyone can do that.
All right, so number three?
Ringo Starr. That's Amanda picked.
Yeah.
He helped shape the Beatles. Once they switched drummers over to him, everything changed from there. And he also sang on Yellow Submarine, too.
So, number two?
My number two is also your number one, Phil Collins.
Phil Collins, yes.
He created that In the Air Tonight. Everyone knows that drum line.
Number one?
Number one, Travis Barker.
Not Animal?
No.
All right, so what do you like about Travis?
I mean, I love that he was kind of like Phil Collins. They both, had a little bit of injuries, but they tried to overcome that. He's had blood clots in both arms, still wanting to play every day. They have a passion for something. They really want to play.
All right, so that's your top five.
Yeah.
So Mark is going to give us the list. Five people sent it in, including Dennis Chambers, who sent it in his pick. So to Mark now.
So Ronnie Carmel, who's the drummer for Slight Return. So, you know, we're going to hit up a drummer to find out who they like. Ronnie's list number five, Steve Smith from Journey, Billy Cobham, Buddy Rich, number two, Dennis Chambers, and number one, of course, John Bonham, which I know Ronnie's as big of a Zeppelin fan as I am a Hendrix fan. We got Ryan Kassab here from the D-Man Foundation, where we're shooting at. Kind enough of them to let us shoot here today. Number five, Bill Ward from Black Sabbath, Pete Sandoval, Mitch Mitchell from the Jimi Hendrix Experience, Keith Moon and John Bonham, Tony Mitchell, who's the percussionist for Slight Return and is also a drummer. He put a couple of percussionists on here. Number five, Carl Perazzo from Santana's band, Raul Rico from Santana's band, Manu Katché, I'm not familiar with his work. Number two, he's got Dennis Chambers, which we all know, and number one, Mitch Mitchell. My buddy Bill Von Linsaway, who does all the cool artwork for Slight Return. Number five is Bill Ward, no surprise there, from Black Sabbath. Number four, Neil Peart. Number three, Mitch Mitchell. Number two, John Bonham. Number one, Keith Moon, which I knew he'd do that because The Who is his favorite band. Chatted with Dennis Chambers earlier today. And as we know, one of the greatest of all time. His list is at number five, James Diamond Williams from the Ohio Players. At number four, Lenny White, who played with bands like Chick Corea. Number three, David Garibaldi, who played with Tower of Power. Tony Williams. And number one on Dennis Chambers' list is Billy Cobham. There you go, we had some participation. And email us your list. We'd like to see what you think, what your, two of your top five drummers on. We're gonna take a short break and be right back.
We're at the D-Man Foundation Studios in Berkeley, Michigan.
I'm very thankful just to be a part of, to be on the executive board and be a volunteer here. And it's called Danny's Miracle Angel Network, the D-Man Foundation. It started when their brother, Danny, got hit by a car and became quadriplegic. And they spent the rest of his life helping him to do normal things. They took him out into the ocean. They took him on flights. They took him to art therapy, which he really loved. They did so many things that were all inclusive for him to make sure that his life was still normal after the injury. So they, in his memory after he passed away, they wanted to open this and have a music therapy studio. So people come in that maybe are quadriplegic, MS, closed head injuries. We have a special studio set up. They can make music by even, they can make beats by blinking their eyes. They have a sip and puff technique where they can blow into like almost a straw and they can create music. We cut singles, record albums, and that, along the path there is, it's also music therapy and they have clinical goals. So their speech becomes better, their abilities, their cognitive abilities become better. We have events that, you know, Ziad and Lexus and the gang, they have events set up like for the Dream Cruise. They have dreams come true on Woodward. So we have a building on Long Lake in Woodward. We set up everything behind and like the Camaro Club donates their cars, convertibles. We bring hoists, pick the D-Man All-Stars up out of their wheelchairs, put them into convertible cars and let them fly up and down Woodward and tear off. Cool. They take them on helicopter rides. Last year they did a cruise, they're doing another cruise this year, which people don't realize how difficult it is because you have to bring the nurse, oxygen tanks. There's a lot of things involved. Well, they took a whole bunch of them on a cruise, had a great time. Just a lot of things that are inclusive that help people out. And like I said, I'm just, we have a Hollywood Nights gala every year. And my band and my bandmates all volunteer our time, and it's just great, a great event. It's at the Lafayette Grand in Pontiac. We have live music, awards. This year, the Mr. Inspire Award, which is named after Eric Thomas, Mr. Inspire himself. Being around them, it's inspirational to me. Like I said, just a great group of guys to work with, and then I try and contribute some stuff to recording on some of the guys' tracks and all that, add some guitar work.
Can't go wrong there.
The last thing you ever want to tell somebody is what they can or cannot do. Danny's Miracle Angel Network Foundation.
Music therapy.
What is music therapy?
Well, the D-Man Foundation is making dreams for the disabled possible.
A board-certified music therapist.
The healing power of music took center stage.
The stars of the show can be an inspiration to us all.
Named after Danny Kassab, he was hit by a car at age 7.
It's really inspiring.
This is incredible.
And it's because of the D-Man Foundation.
With several complications, including a tracheotomy.
This is the Woodward Dream Cruise, and a local nonprofit is making sure that that dream comes true. Out of their wheelchairs and into their favorite convertibles.
Fast, loud, cool, all the above.
D-Man for short.
Waiting for the machine to give you breath makes it challenging.
With some state-of-the-art technology,
allows people with severe disabilities to use computers to record and produce their own music hands-free.
The foundation.
My D-Man Backboard.
Hollywood Night.
Danny, your brother, he wanted to record a rap song.
Thomas, take us better spit what we're saying.
Danny's Miracle Angel Network is hosting its annual Hollywood Night. So what exactly is music therapy? Goals like learning how to breathe without a ventilator.
That's when his older brother Z decided to honor his younger brother's life by giving others the opportunity to live beyond their disability.
We have one mission, and that's to increase the quality of life for people with physical and mental disabilities.
They are known as the D-Man All-Stars.
They are having the rides of their lives.
The D-Man Foundation.
They're changing lives, but not in a traditional way.
Singing their hearts out,
that's
too.
That's right. Doing what they love. Musical therapy.
Talented musicians battling physical and mental disabilities.
And remember that the one who tells themselves that they can and the ones that tell themselves that they can't are both right.
All right, so in this next segment, we're gonna feature our first video, which is the Pale Ways Noises. The song kind of talks about mental health issues and about how she says, basically, is every time someone's passing by her, she wonders, what do they think when they see her? And she goes on about this trip, about that, and how she feels about that, and how she goes on about this in her day, and how it's affected her life. On to that video.
My mind makes noises. Too much. I feel like I'm slowly losing myself. I'm afraid that I need help. It's not
Our next video is by our own RL Recordings artist, mm-hmm. Ripple Street. The video is called How I Feel. Of course, Courtney Gaines, the actor, is the lead singer in that band. So yes, on to that video.
Our next video, we have Allie Keck, which is a part of our label. She has Kiss and Tell.
What I really loved was like the vocals on it. And it had kind of like a smoky, bluesy, but still R&B with a little country thrown in. It just was like all the best parts of all of those types of vocals.
All right, and on to Allie's video.
Trying not to mess things up. I'm trying to act like it don't mean that much to me. 'Cause if your intentions weren't
the same as mine. I may as well be dumb, deaf, and blind. And I'm not crazy for thinking that you want me. Cause you sure as hell act like you do. Well, let's kiss and tell me where this is going. Cause I don't need another waste of time. Let's kiss and tell me what it means to be your Friday night. Let's kiss. Trying not to lose my cool, but I won't change who I am to be the one for you. And I don't need the label, I just need to know where I stand with you. And all that
Our next video is Andy Vargas, The Beat. He's on his own solo project right now. He's also part of Arlo Recordings coming up soon with Slight Return.
I was really loving the tone of the guitar in this one. It like starts out with like a really hot lick.
Yeah, definitely.
With that Latin beat kind of running through it.
Yeah, you can definitely tell a little bit of
Santana. Yeah, uh-huh.
When you go see Andy Vargas coming up soon, he'll be on Vicious Tides with Slight Return on our label.
Let's check out the video.
All right, next to our video.
We're gonna tear it up, tear it up.
gonna do it up, and dance along the floor, yeah. Everybody know, yeah.
We want to discuss the welcometothed.com.
Yeah.
We must mention
your shirts, hats, yeah, mugs, pullovers, whatever you want is there.
Make sure you can see everything, all the videos and everything else that goes on with everything at rlrecordings.com, all the music that goes on at rlrecordings.com.
Slightreturn.com, if you're interested in Slight Return.
Yes, yes. All of some social media, everything I got. So I guess I'd have to say, closing this thing out, you know, thank you for watching this show. Thank you for listening to DCAP. And
we'll see you next time.
Yeah, see you next time.